Previously on the Mask of Inanna.
I pulled you out of your nursing home to finish the prayer. We were so close before you left. It wouldn't take much of your time to end it.
Did it have to be me?
Yes.
You're the teller. You have to be present to tell the stories.
Bob, when I was in Hollywood, Bob was having me finish a ritual for you. You didn't tell me about any monster in the tunnel.
That's our speed bump.
I'm sorry, Len. I told it to keep you here.
Well, what if I want to go? What's your ceremony like?
It's complicated. It's an amalgamation of rituals dating back to Mesopotamia.
But you don't need the mask there?
We have another arcane connection.
The prayer asks what?
Protection for the children! Speed bumps!
What does the speed bump do?
It kills.
Kills her children! In her house!
They're asking for speed bumps to kill the Iraqi people who she loves because they're on her land!
Yes!
Teach her worshippers a lesson they'll never forget.
Why doesn't David know about this?
Does not listen!
Your gorgeous Gwen, who keeps you steady.
I'll need a few days to patch myself together.
You don't have to come back.
Are you just saying that?
Oh, I don't think I need the glass when I have you, Mr. Bottle.
You're not supposed to have alcohol with all that stuff we put in your bloodstream.
I don't care. It's so worth it.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes?
What's going on? What are they making a standard line for?
I don't have a clue.
Okay, everyone has to be inside somewhere. Oh, there it is. Slid out of my bag again. Chris?
Hey.
You've got to get out of here.
I wanted to come by. There's something weird in your tunnel.
They can't find you here.
You weren't answering my phone calls.
No, and... stop. Get in your car, drive, go home. Hurry.
Why did we break up again?
Oh, not now. This is a really bad time. I'll call you later, okay?
Really?
I promise.
Because I was thinking, I can't remember why we broke up. And I hope it wasn't anything I did.
It wasn't.
Oh. What did you do?
Get going! My family made me break up with you. Don't try to remember. I'll get back to you in a few days, okay? Things are bad here.
Okay. I still like you, you know.
This isn't the time.
Okay. I'll see you then.
He get by the speed bump.
The Mask of Inanna.
You can go.
Any other business before we disband? No? Great prayer tonight, folks.
One ritual left. We're close. Before we go, I want to remind us why we're all here. I received another letter from Nicolette yesterday. I'll let you see it. I don't want to read it. I'll read some. Hi, Dad. That's how she always starts. Thanks for the last care package. Donna definitely appreciated the coffee. I hid some funeral incense in the package of coffee. Donna was a friend of hers, killed by a mortar shell on their base. Nicolette doesn't have many people she can talk to in the field. I forgot we had a holiday already. Summer solstice came and went. It doesn't mean much over here. We have the time to celebrate, but none of us do. I know you still don't want me here. I know you say you do, but it's making it hard to read anything you write. I kept your last letter a week before I could open it. She's arguing with me there. I'm going to skip this part. But it's okay. Keep writing. Ask Jessie to send me more of her spiced buns and some dip. I need a few favors on the base. I don't want to know what those are for. I still love you and Mom. It sounds like the church is keeping you busy. I can't wait to come home. Love, Nicolette. One ritual left. We'll see you tomorrow night.
David! Jesse!
How'd you get in here?
Your magic locks don't work on me.
Guys, you have to stop the ritual. It's an insult to Inanna.
What's Len been telling you?
Nothing. She and I heard it from the spirit I was telling you about. The one who sent me back to Adams. The one who flipped the lighthouse today. It's been trying to tell me that your ritual is going to piss the dickens out of Inanna.
Iraq is her home. It doesn't matter that no one is worshipping her there. It's like we're asking her to start killing people in her own hometown.
Remember what you told me happened the night you asked Inanna if you should finish the ritual?
She sent me the thunderstorm after I finished praying.
And what happened after I performed my first show at the lighthouse?
We had another thunderstorm.
It blew in my front door. Jesse had to clean up the mess. A thunderstorm is not approval. Inanna is shouting no to you.
She's a warrior goddess. She doesn't send rainbows and unicorns to show her favor.
She sends dreams and demons. Not thunderstorms.
Jesse.
I know how she works.
I don't believe it.
We should look into it. How are you sure that the voice came from the same spirit?
The winged creatures tried to kill it twice. They got it on the second try.
Was Gwen with you both times?
Yes.
How do you know the voice wasn't hers?
Because she was holding back the wing creatures while the voice spoke to me. We weren't in the same room.
She could fake the wing creatures, too.
Not when they took her face off. Humor me. Can you change the ritual? Ask for a magic shield or something.
Changing the ritual at this stage is very difficult.
But can you do it?
Not in 2 weeks.
I want to see more proof. I'm sorry. I can't take your word on this.
Then come to the lighthouse. Do whatever you have to do.
But you said the spirit is gone. We can't bring it back.
Then ask another. There must be more of them in there.
I can try, but what guarantee do I have that any of them will tell the truth?
You don't have a choice. Until you find a way to change the prayer, I quit.
We've been through this before.
No! I have gone through hell for you. Your bump attacked me. Your rivals kidnapped me. And my Gwen almost died trying to make sure I heard this message. For all I have done for you, the least you can do is give me the benefit of the doubt.
I helped carry Gwen to the water. See? I have her mucus on my shirt. We have to change the ritual. I don't want my brother to get hurt by it.
I'm not changing it.
Inanna would have spoken to us.
Like the thunderstorms?
Yes.
Then you have a problem. Because I'm not setting one foot in the lighthouse until you change your ritual to something Inanna approves of.
You're condemning my daughter. All of our children.
Would I raise this much of a stink if I didn't think the alternative was worse?
I think you imagined the spirit's voice. Gwen was using you.
Oh, come off it. I'm a dead man. The Mammons couldn't mind game me. I've said my piece. I'm going out.
You're going to stay here. You can't leave us like that. You haven't read my daughter's letters. You don't have anyone you love in the war. Maybe you can sit by and do nothing, but how can you expect the same of me?
Hey!
Let him leave. He needs to burn off steam.
He does. What about us?
We'll talk tomorrow, Len.
I'm not scared of you or your talk. I'm scared of what I heard tonight. The lighthouse spirits and the storms. None of this is right. You're headed for disaster, and I won't be part of it. Unless you can scare me more than your goddess does. You don't see him caring what happened to Gwen, do you?
I messed up.
What's the matter?
I should have recorded the voice.
Jesse would have said it was faked anyway.
I guess.
Christ, Main Street's dark at, what, 9:45? Is there anywhere you can get coffee and a burger?
Everything closes at 9. Nobody's supposed to have a life.
I wish Gwen was around. She used to make the juiciest burgers. And now she's gone. I don't know if I'm going to last long enough to see her again.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, too. You'll get through this. You're strong.
I try.
I need to get off the island. Mr. Lewis and Miss McAllister are going to grind me down until I change my mind.
Where would you go?
Around. Do you want to do something for me?
Sure.
Do you have any walkie-talkies?
At my house? Yeah.
Let's get them. Then drive me to the marina. I want to try something. Scotty?
I'm in the tunnel.
Good. Keep your eye on the bump. I'm going for a boat.
Aye, aye.
Evening.
Evening. Okay, which boat? No oars, but should work. Right on time. Okay, I'm leaving. Watch me. I'm going. It's here. It's watching me.
It vanished while I had my light on it. Now it's back.
It's gone now. So, it can't be in two places at once.
I can travel pretty far.
We're done tonight. Do you have a guest room I can use?
Sure, Sam won't mind.
Come pick me up. I'm beat. I want my Gwen back. I want to sleep. Morning.
You weren't in your room when I checked on you.
I woke up early. I wanted to wait for Gwen.
You should have left me a note.
I'm sorry. I will next time.
Has Gwen come yet?
No.
It's weird. Ms. McAllister hasn't shown up to chew me out yet.
She's scared of us. You know why. You're a prophet now.
I don't feel prophetic.
Go back to your church. Tell them everything. See the looks you get.
I know.
How much have I told you about my days in the movie business?
Not much.
I met quite a few big names. I met... someone you've heard of. Oh, I met Ed Wood.
Really?
Sure. I was helping a friend of mine on his set when I ran into Ed.
Can move the dialogue here. Hey, you!
Yes, sir?
Give me a cup of coffee.
Right away, sir.
At least, I think he was Ed Wood.
I think I bumped into one of the guys from Aerosmith at the farmer's market.
Oh, Mutiny on the Bounty. Bora Bora, Tahiti, 1962. I was there.
I've never seen it.
Oh, you should. Incredible sets. Took weeks to build. Music that would bring a tear to your eye. Marlon Brando at his height. And so many women. Miles of scantily clad women extras.
So this is a guy movie?
I suppose so. Now, Rosenberg, the producer, wasn't happy with the script, so they brought me in to give the principals some better lines. Harris, Griffith, Howard? Nobody you've heard of. I couldn't touch Brando's. Of course, Milestone, the director, didn't want me there, so he shuffled me off to help manage set design.
So you met Brando?
No, couldn't get near him. Anyway, he was spending the studio's money like it was water. He had crates of meat and booze flown in every other day. He'd call the set crew whenever he needed a project done. He had him design a friend's wedding once. Since I was watching the books for the set crew, I kept having to get my friend Rick out of the jams that would come up. One day, Rick gets a notice from on high that Brando has ordered himself one of those smoking monkeys and needs a cage for it.
For a plastic monkey?
No, a real one, like they had at the circus. A chimpanzee that someone had taught how to smoke a cigar.
Chimps aren't monkeys. And ew.
Well, it was a different time. The order says Brando wants the cage on a patio outside his bedroom window. He's off the island for a few days, and the chimp's on its way, so we don't have a lot of time to build it. We're sinking the supports, laying the flats down, and making good progress. Then it occurs to Rick and me that Brando has a very beautiful view of the ocean. And when he gets back and looks out his window, expecting a beautiful view, he's gonna see a chimpanzee, probably dressed like him, smoking a cigar in a cage instead. Brando was putting on some weight. And we get to thinking, maybe Brando didn't order the chimp. Someone else on high is trying to send him a message. And Brando's gonna tear us a new one when he finds out.
What happened to the chimp?
I raced down to the airport and have it sent back to the States. I was screaming at the delivery people, telling them Brando was out for their blood. But Rick still has to deal with the cage. It has a concrete floor 10 feet over the ground. We don't have time to take it down properly. And then, Rick owes me forever for this. I say we make it into a barbecue pit. Brando had all that food coming, right? He's not thrilled, but he was grilling up pork on it last I heard.
Yeah, I would've.
Exactly. I'm wanting barbecue now. Those ribs Mr. Lewis brought the other day were good.
I love the place that makes them.
We should go sometime.
Jesus! David! How long have you been there?
You were telling the story so well. We didn't want to interrupt.
And you, Jesse?
Any sign of Gwen?
No. She said she needed a few days to herself.
About last night, you really caught me in a bad spot. I lost my temper and I was too hard on you.
I'm just the messenger. I know what people do to messengers.
We spoke with our inner circle after you left. We have a ritual for reawakening memories. We'd like to see what you two saw.
Sure. Crack open the old coconut and have a look.
We want Scotty.
Oh.
It's not an easy ritual. You don't have to do it.
I will. It was last night. I'm sure it'll come back clear.
Then we should start preparing. I'll make sure it's safe, honey.
We'll be done before noon. Will you still be here?
I might be at the library. They're showing me how to use the internet.
I can drive you.
Lead on.
One more time, hon.
Okay.
Did you find out what you needed?
What does the speed bump do?
It kills.
Kills her children in her house. This is what will be asked. Death on her doorstep. Bumps will kill her own. A grave insult.
Teach her worshippers a lesson they'll never forget.
You cannot ask if this is the answer.
I'm bleeding.
Enough.
Relax and return, hon. Don't hold on. That wasn't too bad.
Wow. I couldn't focus at all. And I kept hearing Gwen.
It's fine. Just sit up.
I need some water.
Can I go?
Yes. Just wait in the foyer for us. What are you trying to do to her? You already lied to her about Len's dosages, and you can't even thank her for sharing her thoughts?
I couldn't hold it in. I don't get why the spirit said I'm not listening. I have been listening. Do you think it was Gwen?
She'd have had to do a heck of a good job.
Of course.
I'll tell Scotty to go home.
This is a test, isn't it?
It's a problem.
Did you believe the spirit?
Yes. But that's what you get from mind-reading voices. They can make anything sound true.
Why didn't we hear something sooner? Why did she save this trial for the last?
Sleep on it. See what you think tomorrow.
We should call the inner circle in. Let's gotta go home.
All right.
You're sure you've been listening to Inanna closely?
I've been lied to by more spirits than you. I don't trust the nice ones as far as I can throw them.
Good.
But Len does have a point about the thunderstorms.